Isaiah chapter 30, verse 15. It says, your salvation or your redemption lies in repentance and quietness. Say your redemption lies in you being calm. Stay one place. Then verse 16, he said, but you people will not have it. Rather, you want to flee to here. You want to run to here. And then go and read it. Isaiah 30 from verse 15 to 17. Say, and all you want to do is to be running up and down. He said, okay, since you have decided to run, keep running. He said, your pursuers and attackers, they will increase. He was talking to people of Israel who were looking for help, helter skelter, without repairing their life. He said, keep running. Those who are attacking you, they will do what? Check all those people who are deliverance crazy. Do they stop with one? They don't stop with one. Look at Psalm 1. Happy indeed is the man who does not sit in the counsel of the wicked, nor lingers in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of scorners, but whose delight is in the law of the Lord his God, who ponders on his law day and night. He's like what? A tree planted where? Beside the flowing waters, that yields its fruit in due season. And whatever he does, he shall do what? He shall succeed. Why will he succeed? Because his root is in the water. Your problem is you don't have root. That's why you keep running up and down. Psalm 92, from verse 12. The righteous planted in the courts of the Lord, he shall do what? He shall flourish like the palm tree. Okay, let me just pray for you. You shall flourish like the palm tree. I say you shall flourish like the palm tree. Your head shall flourish like the palm tree. Your marriage will flourish like the palm tree. I say your businesses shall flourish like the palm tree. Your life will flourish like the palm tree. Take that scripture to heart. Say the righteous planted, flourish like the palm tree, like the cedar of Lebanon. He said, they shall be fruitful even in old age because they are planted. God planted you. Nothing can uproot you. Don't let weeds around distract you. Tell somebody your business is to grow. Your business is to grow. And I mean it. Your business is to do what? Grow. Don't matter about the demons, the weeds around. There are angels that will take care of them. From today, stop doing the work of your angels. Let them take care of this. Your business needs to grow. You have been given the grace to grow. Focus on it. The energy you would have used to grow, that's what you are using to run up and down. Grow. God will protect you. Say the Lord is our protector. Okay? Second reason why he didn't want them to uproot this thing, because you cannot differentiate between the weed and the wheat. They look alike. The only time you will know the difference is when they have grown to harvest time. The wheat will produce fruit or seed. You will now see. The wheat does not produce, or they won't be different. There may be many interpretations to this, but this thing is that we are all intertwined. If you want God to apply justice, share the Bible says in Romans 3, for all have. If God were to be 100% just, now how many of us will remain here? Then in each of us also, there is some evil. That's what you should focus on, the evil that is in you, to remove it, diminish it. Don't matter about the evil outside. The evil you should be restless about to remove is the one that is what? Inside me, not the evil people around. So you need to be patient.
To watch full videos and get notifications for new ones, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. God bless you.
Sign up with the largest community of Catholics online. Meet new friends, chat, post pictures and videos, make and receive audios and video calls, interact with lots of priests and religions. Download the app from Google Play Store.